5 tonight in this historic snowfall in the Northeast. The first flight to Washington, D.C. isn't for another couple of hours.
From lawmakers on down, folks in D.C. have been paralyzed by what they call Snowmageddon. And its impact is being felt at CVG.
And tonight we were given exclusive airport access. Brian Hamrick is live with our number one story. Brian?
Yeah, Cherie, we got a backstage pass to the clearing operation here, one that has kept CVG running smoothly. Unfortunately, the same cannot be said at some of the East Coast airports where, well, unfortunately, they've had a couple of feet of snow.
It's a job that's piled up the work as high as some buildings. Crews here at CVG gave us exclusive access to show just how they clear the road to the sky. Even though planes can leave the airport, travelers here are still caught up in the cascade of cancellations.
Unfortunately, we tried to leave yesterday, but that never happened because of the snowstorm.
Robert Kugler is a funeral director from New Jersey, here with his daughter visiting Batesville Casket Company when the same storm that hit us unloaded on the East Coast.
We're here for a couple days, and that turned into about 3 or 4 days.
The ripple effect has the cancellation board still lit up. Few flights to Baltimore and New York. First flights in 3 days are expected to go from CVG into Washington tonight. And there are snow problems you'd never figure.
We were supposed to go this morning, and her passport didn't get here because of all the snow down south.
Keisha Faulkner missed her flight to Korea because her infant daughter's passport got stuck in the snow somewhere along the trucking route. What's even more bizarre, when it finally gets here, this pile of snow will still be here too, even if it's July. Imagine a snow pile 6 months old. That's some snow pile. Now, they tell us the main thing to remember is that if you're going east, any of those airports, be sure and check with your airlines before you go. There could be problems out there. We're going to have more of our exclusive snow tour, plus the Abrams tank of snow removal devices. We'll show that coming up at 6. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, News 5.